But the day of the Lord will come as a thief in the night.
See, you walking up and down having a good weekend, you ain't thinking that God gonna kill you this weekend. You don't think God gonna kill your mother and father this weekend. You don't think God gonna kill your children this weekend. You don't fear the power of the Most High. You think the Lord playing with you, black man and black woman. God said to lay up your folly ground in this empire, man. Who you think you dealing with, man? You dealing with the almighty power. You sit up there and listen to these stupid white people if you want to. These white people think that their computers can save them from the hand of the Lord. You think your technology can save you from the hand of God. Are you out your damn mind? Are you simple and crazy as you could be? God made man on this earth. The white man ain't make man. God made man. And God want man to obey him.
ISUPK.
Yet we're seeing these wars and these rumors of wars. We're watching Trump do what he do. We're watching North Korea do what they do. We're watching the Arabs suit up and boot up. But this ain't the end yet. This ain't the end yet.
Hey brother, you bringing out a most powerful point. Do this world understand what's about to happen to you, black man and black woman? You going about your life every day and you enjoying yourself and having a good weekend and going to the restaurant. But do you know that you're about to be part of the third world's war? Are you aware of that? Are you aware of what is about to happen to you and your families in this earth? And did you know that God prophesied that in this time that he would come back and destroy this earth that you're standing on?
That's right.
Do you know that God believes in right justice in this earth? That God is mad with the earth. That God is mad with the treatment of people on the planet earth by the governments of this earth. Many of you go to church on Sunday, and I got a question for you. If you go to church on Sunday and you say you believe in Jesus, and you believe that Jesus is coming back, I got a question for you. When Jesus comes back to the earth, is Jesus going to take over the governments of the world? According to the Bible, you better believe he's going to take over the governments of the world. And if Jesus is going to take over the governments of the world, what's going to happen to these governments on the earth? God going to destroy these governments on the earth, man. Give me 2 Peter. You've been afraid of this Bible. A lot of you Christians been in church saying, I don't want to read Revelation. You don't want to read Revelation because you don't want to face the truth like the brother bringing out. Don't go nowhere, you all right? You don't want to face the truth that God coming to this earth and he's going to bring destruction on this earth. Keep enjoying your life. Y'all going to have a good weekend this weekend? You got plans for this weekend? Well, get ready for the plans of God. And the plans of God is not going to be as nice and sweet as you think it's going to be. I'm going to read it for you right now. Give me the second book of Peter, man. And let's go read about it in the second book of Peter and find out if God's going to be nice and sweet when he get back in this earth. You've been playing with the word of God in your churches, man. You've been in church singing and dancing, playing with the choir. Give me 2 Peter. I think I want 3 and 10? Let me see where you at. Oh, yeah. Oh yeah, that's it. 2 Peter 3:10 out of the King James Bible. They done took this Bible for a joke, but this book ain't gonna be no joke no more. You're gonna deal with this book here. All manner of evil has been being performed in Washington, D.C. against the people of God. You've been taking God for a joke in this town. You've been acting like God don't exist and he got nothing to do with nothing. But you're gonna see God and his full power when he begin to destroy this earth for the evil that's being done in this place, man. I'm gonna read it for you, brother. Read it out this book, man.
Book of 2 Peter 3:10. But the day of the Lord will come as a thief in the night.
See, you walking up and down having a good weekend, you ain't thinking that God gonna kill you this weekend. You don't think God gonna kill your mother and father this weekend. You don't think God gonna kill your children this weekend. You don't fear the power of the Most High. You think the Lord playing with you, black man and black woman. God said to lay up your folly ground in this empire, man. Who you think you dealing with, man? You dealing with the almighty power. You sit up there and listen to these stupid white people if you want to. These white people think that their computers can save them from the hand of the Lord. You think your technology can save you from the hand of God. Are you out your damn mind? Are you simple and crazy as you could be? God made man on this earth. The white man ain't make man. God made man. And he want God want man to obey him. You better do what he said. You better put up your folly ground. You better stop smoking cigarettes. Stop getting high. You better stop robbing and stealing and killing all over towards one another. You black women, you married to a man, you better stop snooping around. You better stop dressing like a $2 hoe, walking up and down in D.C. and disrespecting the body that God gave you, man. What the hell is wrong with you? Who you think you playing with? God is angry in this earth, man. And he's gonna bring judgment down, man. And it's gonna be bad. It ain't gonna be nice and sweet and pretty like that preacher been telling you. That preacher in the church, he lying to you, man. He ain't telling you what's gonna happen. Read that up.
And the which the heavens shall pass away with a great noise.
You hear what God said? He said the heavens shall pass away with great noise. What does that mean? Does that mean up in heaven where God ain't gonna pass away? That's ridiculous. Why would God get rid of his own heaven? He ain't talking about his heaven. He talking about the heaven you living in. You know why God want to destroy your heaven? Because you think it's all right to be gay and lesbians. That's why God going to destroy your heaven. You want to know why God going to destroy your heaven? Because instead of sitting down and studying the Bible, you in church singing and dancing and acting a damn fool every Sunday. And God is getting angry with you, black man, black woman. Are you ready for the diseases God gonna bring on this earth? Did you know that God said he would punish us with all the diseases of Egypt because of the wickedness that we're doing against the Lord? Yeah, you don't want to deal with the Most High now. Oh, you don't want to see nothing about no Bible now, huh? Why that preacher singing and dancing, why that homosexual is in charge of the choir, you ain't got no problem with God. But when I open up the Bible and read about God in the Bible, then you're upset mad. Then you don't want it. General, don't talk about that. Don't talk about that. Well, it's in the Bible. I thought you believed in God, black man, black woman. Well, here's what God said. Here's what your God is talking about. And he ain't happy with your behavior. He is not happy with your behavior in this empire, man. Read up.
And the elements shall melt with fervent heat.
He gonna burn this place with fervent heat. What's gonna burn this place with fervent heat? Global thermonuclear war. They getting ready for it right now. Donald Trump done send the troops down into Southeast Asia. Are you ready? Are you ready for the draft, black man and black woman? Are you ready for the white man to put you in a green suit and give you a machine gun and ship your behind off to the middle of nowhere and tell you to go fight the Koreans? Are you ready for the life that God is about to give you, black man, black woman, for your disobedience, man? For your disobedience to the Lord. How you gonna sit up there and let the white man tell you that homosexuality and lesbianism is all right? Who in the hell told you black women that it was all right to kill your baby in the abortion clinic? Who in the hell taught you that damn lie? Why didn't you inquire about God? Why didn't you ask God, God, is it all right that I murder my baby in Planned Parenthood? Why the hell you ain't asked the Lord that? Oh, you don't want to hear about this now. Oh, I want to go home now. Let's get off that corner. Let's get away from him, man. He sound crazy. He sound crazy. I'm reading out of your book, black man, black woman. I'm reading out of your Bible. I'm reading out of the book you said God is in. Why, when I start reading out of God's word, now you mad and upset because you've been doing evil in this earth. You've been getting away with wickedness in a D.C. for too damn long. You've been getting high, robbing, shooting, stealing, killing, raping, living a lascivious life against the almighty power, and now he want to require it at your hand, man. God wants you to be a righteous people, man. God wants you to be an honorable people. That's what the Lord want out of you. You think God wants you walking around in this old evil spirit? Hell no, right or wrong. That's the wrong spirit, man. So he said, you know what? They don't want to listen to me, no problem. I'm going to burn up the whole damn earth on them. I'm going to destroy every kingdom on this earth. What you think is happening over there in Southeast Asia? Oh, I can't wait. All you old Billy Bad Boys, Rambo, what's the name of them? Where you all, you SEAL Team 6, y'all get ready. Y'all get ready because you about to be called up to the Third World's War according to the Bible. Give me some more, huh? Give me some more.
The earth also and the works that therein.
The earth and the works therein. Meaning all these kingdoms on this planet. You see this corner you standing on? These big movie theaters and all these restaurants? The Lord about to destroy every one of them. He gonna burn this empire down to the ground. You know why? Because you want to be wicked. You want to be evil. You want to do everything that the Lord said not to do. How dumb and stupid could you be? God made man. He know man better than man know himself. How you will not listen to God, knowing that God is the one that made your dumb, simple, stupid behind? You gonna sit up there listening to the white man like the white man got some intelligence or something. The white man don't believe in God. The white man is the devil, the Bible speaks of. And you listening to the white man like he got intelligence and he know how life's supposed to go in this damn earth. You better follow what the Lord said, because God is gonna be the final judge on the face of this planet earth, man. And he gonna require it of you, brother. He gonna want you to get right. How you gonna let the white man turn you into a drug dealer? You gonna let the white man turn you into a drug dealer and go around selling poison, committing chemical warfare on other black people? How dumb and stupid and brainwashed could you be? And you think God ain't gonna put you to death for the evil that you doing, man? Is that what you think? You think the evil gonna just go on and on and on, and the Lord ain't never gonna step in the middle of it and do something about it? I'm reading it for you now. For all you Bible.
For all you everybody, for all you Bible token Christians, for all you Sunday morning, holy rolling Christians, God about to deal with you. Give me a little round of applause.
The earth also in the works that they're in.
Said the works and the things that are in this earth, he said he's gonna burn it up. He's gonna burn this place up. Y'all ready for the Third World War? I know you white men ready. Y'all can't wait to get it on, right? You gonna get the AR-15 out? You gonna get ready to go to town on them old enemies, aren't you? Are you ready for it yet? Well, guess what? You better get ready. You better get your sons ready. The whole world is getting ready to go to war. And people gonna die on this earth.
People are going to die on this earth by the millions. You know why? Because don't nobody want to do what God said. You want to do what you want to do. But God said you're going to do what I tell you to do. You ain't going to do what you want to do. You're going to do what the Lord said. Either you're going to do it, or he's going to show you that he rules this earth and not man. Go from there and give me the book of Isaiah. No, matter of fact, give me what you hold. All right, come on with it. Tell me where you at.
Isaiah chapter 14, verse 21.
Before you go to 21, read the first verse for me. The first and second verse.
Isaiah chapter 14, verse 1.
See, you know what your problem is, black man and black woman in America? You have stopped listening to what God said. You let the white man tell you the Bible ain't true. The Bible a bunch of old legends. The Bible is a fairy tale. There's different interpretations of the Bible. God come in many names and many religions. You better stop listening to this lying white man, man. And you better start listening to what God said in that Bible. That Bible is the word of God. And he is about his business. And if you disrespect that word, God will punish you in your disrespect. The white man was evil on this earth. That's why you got 15 years in Afghanistan. You went to 15 years in Afghanistan, lost all your sons and daughters. Sent hundreds of thousands of brothers back with missing arms and missing legs. You know why? Because you don't listen to God. You too busy listening to some dumb politician that's using you to fill his pockets full of money. I know you got hope in Trump. I know you think Trump gonna change everything. Trump gonna get rich off of you, man. Trump gonna get rich off of you and he gonna be gone and America gonna keep this evil going. You had better fear the Lord. You know what God said in the Bible? You let this noise pass, y'all. The Lord said the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. You know what that means? You know what that means? But Shock, I can't get no more on it, huh? That's it. You know what that means? When the Lord said the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom, meaning this, you want to be a smart man in the earth? You could be a dumb man in the earth or you could be a smart man in the earth. I'm going to tell you how to be a smart man in the earth. The way to be a smart man in the earth is to be fearful of what God said. Meaning, to make sure that when you live in your life and you going about your daily life, to make sure that you doing it according to God. To make sure that you not fearing the Lord. I mean, that you not crossing the Lord. When you come across a situation where you could rob the store or not rob the store, you got to check with God. When you open the Bible, the Lord said, thou shalt not steal. So what are you supposed to do? Even though it looked like you can get over, you still supposed to say, I'm not going to rob the store. Because the Lord said, thou shalt not steal. You see, your church and your school have never taught you no morals, black man, black woman. And the white man certainly ain't going to teach you no morals because he's an immoral animal on the face of this earth. How you going to ask a murderous animal like the white man to teach you morals in the earth? Are you stupid? You walking up and down on the North American Indian bones. The North American Indian buried right under the ground right here. Now why the hell would you think a white man would teach you right and wrong when he done murdered the Indians and he walking on top of that? Right. How dumb can we be? That's why you got to stop listening to him and start obeying God. And once you start living your life with that fear, guess what? Guess what? You're going to get right. And you're going to become powerful. And you're going to become strong. And then you and your children going to escape the third world war. God is bringing the third world's war to this earth. Whether you like it or not, accept it or not, or whether you deal with it or not, you're going to be a part of it in this earth. I'm going to show it to you some more. Here's what the Lord said. Here's what God said in the Bible that the preacher never brings out. Them preachers never open this book up and show you this. Read,
Isaiah chapter 14, verse 1. For the Lord will have mercy on Jacob.
You hear what the Lord said? He gonna have mercy on Jacob. Who's Jacob? Jacob is one of the 12 lost tribes of the children of Israel that you see listed on that sign. Them 12 tribes of Israel, those are God's chosen people. Those are the children of Jacob. You white people, I'm sorry, you not the chosen people. I know you done been lied to. They made Jesus white. You walked around with a white Jesus thinking all this time, well, God must be down with us because Jesus white. Somebody lied. Somebody lied to you. God's chosen people are dark-skinned people with woolly hair.
Who in the hell told you the Bible had white people in it? Well, I got a simple question for you. When have a white man ever come out the Middle East, dummy? How the hell you gonna believe Jesus was white and ain't no white people never come out the Middle East? You go to the Middle East, all the people dark skin, but all of a sudden, the Savior, all of a sudden, he white. How dumb can you be, man? Jesus wasn't a white man. Jesus was a black man with woolly hair, according to the Bible. The white man couldn't tell you that, because then that would mean a black man was greater than him. And how could you push white supremacy if Jesus is black? So in order to push white supremacy on everybody else, he had to teach everybody that Jesus was white. That was the only way to brainwash everybody. And Negroes, you running in church for years. For years, you black people was going to church praying to some white Jesus up on the wall. Jesus helped and saved me while crack pouring in your ghetto. Jesus helped save me while heroin was pouring in your ghetto. Jesus helped save me while they setting up abortion clinics exterminating your people. Jesus helped save me while they sitting around doing housing scandals on you. You know why Jesus ain't never answered your prayer? Jesus ain't never answered your prayer because Jesus wasn't that white boy you was praying to. That's why he ain't answer your prayer. You should have prayed to the real Jesus. A black man with woolly hair, brother. The white man tell you it's equality in America. All men are created equal. Ain't that what he said? Then why in the hell he don't tell the truth that Jesus was a black man? Then color don't matter, why you don't tell the truth? Jesus Christ was a black man. Deal with it. You white people always make yourself the savior. You turn on Star Trek, the damn astronauts and the space people is white. You gonna make a movie about you in the depths of the ocean, they white. You make a cowboy Indian movie, you make the cowboy white and the Indian white. That's exactly right, brother. But this Bible is what deciphers what is right and wrong. And how did the Lord open it up to you? By you fearing the Lord and obeying the Lord. You obey the Lord, you'll never become a crack dealer. Don't you know the white man love to see you as old crack dealer, old filthy thing, sitting in the middle of the ghetto destroying your own people so he can be proud and feel good and say, see, there go the niggers. See, that's right. There they go. See, they don't know how to control themselves. They don't have any discipline. Meanwhile, he the one bringing all the dope in the ghetto to poison everybody with. But if you open up the Bible, you'll figure it out. Then you'll be like, hell no, we ain't doing that. And really, you ain't got to worry in a minute anyway. In a minute, let me tell yourself what you about to see in a minute in America. You're going to come to Washington, D.C., and you're going to say to yourself, where are all the men at in Washington, D.C.? You know why? Because there's going to be a major deficit of men in this country. You know why it's going to be a major deficit? Because they're going to be all in the Middle East, in Southeast Asia, in Africa, and all over the world fighting in the Third World's War. That's right. The Bible never lied. You going to the Third World's War according to the biblical prophecy. Stay with me. Let me show you some more. Read. And will yet choose Israel.
The Lord said he going to yet choose Israel. He going to yet choose Israel. He didn't choose Israel for a while. Why? Because we were sinning against the Lord. But once we start getting right, then the Lord will choose Israel. Right now, God is allowing your enemy to rule. God allowing your enemy to rule. But once you begin to obey the Lord, once you begin to do what the Lord said, God gonna choose you, black man and black woman, and your life gonna change for the better. Your mother and father gonna get off of drugs. Your sister gonna stop being a nasty hoe. Your family members is gonna stop killing their babies in the abortion clinic. You gonna stop worshiping the gods of all these nations around the world. You gonna get the black woman out the Christian church, the worst place on earth for any black woman. You wanna know where the worst place on earth is for any black woman? Your American Christian church. That's the worst place in the world. If you got a woman to go to church on Sunday, pull the spark plugs out the car so she can't go to church. You're going to have a better marriage. You're going to have a better marriage. If she put the spark plugs back in, crash the car into a pole.
Make sure you don't never, ever let your woman go to that filthy whorehouse called the church. And I dare Christian to take me on with it. I dare Christian to open their damn mouth today about no Christian church. I'm finna tear your Christian pastor up. Don't you dare tell me nothing about no black Christian church, because they don't do nothing God say in this Bible. You don't, if I tell you, tell, name me five laws in the Bible, you Christians can't say nothing. You see them running, right? All the Christians out. I pull five laws, they gone. You know what I'm saying? Because they know good and well they don't know the Bible. Because you don't learn about God in church. You know what you learn how to do in church? You learn how to accept every evil thing that goes on in the earth. You don't learn how to serve the Lord. You think God wants you sitting in the church singing and dancing and clapping your hands all day? God wants you to get out here and fix the people that's destroyed out here. He don't want you sitting in some building all day Sunday singing and dancing and then go down to the basement and eat all the ham hocks and cornbread you could stuff down your damn gullet. You think that's serving God? That ain't serving God. That's serving yourself. You serve God by going and helping fix the people of God. And why you think black people ain't get fixed in Washington, D.C.? Because your preacher's too busy sitting in that big giant church he in, instead of out here doing what the hell God told him to do. Give me some more, huh?
For the Lord will have mercy on Jacob.
God gonna have mercy on you, black man and black woman. Why? Because you're the seed of Jacob. You're the seed of the 12 lost tribes of the children of Israel. Ask yourself a question, black man and black woman, especially those of you that go to church. I got a simple question that you should ask yourself. What is the nationality of black people before they came to America? Can you tell? Hell no, you can't tell. What language did black people speak before they came to America? Can you tell me? No, you can't tell. What kind of food did black people eat before they came to America in cargo slave ships? Can you tell me? Hell no, you can't tell me. You know why you can't tell me? Because your identity been wiped away from you. You know why your identity was wiped away? Because they never wanted you to find out that you were the 12 lost tribes of the children of Israel, man. They don't want you to know this. But you need to find out, wake up to this. You know why? Because God is bringing the third world's war to America. Matter of fact, give me Revelation 18. Give me all the third world's war good stuff. Y'all know what I want. Give me Revelation 18, brother. God gonna come and destroy. Matter of fact, which one got Babylon in, 18 or 17? Give me which one I want. Yeah, that's it. Give me 18 and 2. Give me Revelation 18 and 2. This is the book they don't like to talk about. You know that. They don't like to open this book. But we're going to open up some of this book today. We're going to show you what's in this book today. You've been listening to the dumb, stupid white man for too long. It's about time you hear what God said. You old, silly, stupid black women, a lot of you is dumb as hell. You sitting in church on Sunday singing and dancing thinking you serving God when you are working completely against God. A lot of you sitting in church listening to homosexual preachers teach you how to hate black men. A lot of you black women got a subconscious hatred for black men and you don't even realize it, right or wrong, huh? And you be wondering why the black woman got such an attitude with you. She don't even know why. I'm telling you why. Because you sat in that church with some homosexual sitting on the podium teaching you how to hate black men, teaching you how black men ain't nothing, teaching you how black men is degenerate, when black men is the one that's going to save and deliver the evil life you live in. And if you don't think a black man is necessary, because I know you women, you are, what they call them? You are the ones that, about women rights. What they call them things? Feminists, right? You feminists talking about we don't need no man. We don't need no man. How, let me ask you, I got a simple test. How do you know that black men is absolutely essential and needed in the ghetto? How do you know that? How do you know that? Because black men ain't in the houses in the ghetto, and look at the ghetto, dummy. Like if black men wasn't needed, why the ghetto full of crime and murder and drugs? Because ain't no black men there, that's why. So how the hell you gonna act like a black man ain't necessary when a black man is the most necessary part of the family, man? The black man is more important than the woman, the children, the dog, the house, the garage, the car, everything. He's the most important factor in the entire family complex. Without him, nothing functions right. And that's why the ghetto is such a mess right now. But God raising up black men to fix the ghetto. Why? Because he's about to bring the third world's war to your doorstep. He's about to bring the third world's war to your doorstep. White people ran out and voted a white supremacist, a damn Nazi in the White House. You done put Adolf Hitler in the damn White House. Well, you about to pay for it now, because Adolf Hitler about to send your sons and daughters to die across this world. So get ready. Get ready to deal, to reap what you sow. God said, whatsoever a man soweth, that shall he reap. You done sowed white supremacy for 400 years in America. Get ready to reap God's punishment for it. Get ready to reap God's judgment for it. I'm reading it to you now. I ain't got no special Bible. This the same Bible they swear you in court. This the same Bible your preacher got in the church that never reads in the book of Revelation. This the same Bible that preacher in the church lies to you with. I'm going to tell you the truth out the Bible. Read it for me, all right?
Revelation chapter 18, verse 2. And he cried mightily with a strong voice, saying, Babylon the great is fallen.
You hear what God said? Babylon the great is fallen. Why is this place called Babylon the great? Ancient Babylon was a city of confusion. Why was ancient Babylon considered a city of confusion? Because ancient Babylon tried to bring all different ethnic groups together. And he tried to bring it together in a melting pot. And God came down and destroyed that melting pot. You don't believe me? Go read Genesis the 9th, 10th, and 11th chapter. God will tell you about the Tower of Babel. How they tried to bring all the people together as one, just like America does. America tried to bring all people together. Give me your tire, your poor, your
huddle masses. But what they should have been doing is trying to give every man and every nation their own land,
their own position. This is what they should have been doing. Instead, they try to bring all nations together. You done angry the Lord, Mr. White Man. I'm sorry, Mr. White Man. You done went against God's word. And you done took God for a joke. You done went into outer space and went to the moon and decided that God don't exist. Well, God is about to show you that he do exist. And he about to show you what he do when you cross the line with God. He about to show it to you. Read.
It's fallen and it's become the habitation of devil.
You hear what the Lord said? God said that this place gonna fall. That Babylon the Great is fallen and have become the habitation of devils, man. This place is full of demons and evil and wickedness, man. That's why every month.
I don't let nobody tell you crap. You know why? Because I never saw you before. But you are a black man like me.
No, sir. And it's workshop.
My whole life was trying to find something to follow. Had loyalty, every man tried to borrow. Felt pain and a lot of sorrow. Got betrayed, sold packs, I didn't even have my heart broke. Living confused, about to lose hope. Cops got me on the side of the road, like a sideshow. Need an antidote before I croak. Now I'm setting fire to rhythm man blues, call this guitar smoke. Rebel with no cause, trying to find direction. The world got me vexed. Picked up a bad liquor habit that's already turned from oppression. Felt like my life was on fire, trying to find an exit. Now look, 10 G's plus a good record. Sometimes a follower is a soldier, trying to find a good shepherd. Plus when you in hell, how do you excel? Wisdom, the breath of life, I believe in fairy tale. Listen well to what I tell. No calling can cause pain. Something that a rebel knows very well. Can't you tell I was sent from the Lord? Got a tongue like a two-edged sword.